Hey everyone, in case you're unaware, AMD AM5 motherboards powered by the newly released mid-range B650E and B650 chipsets are now available for purchase on the market. For today's video, we'll be taking a look at a motherboard that sports the entry-level AMD B650 chipset and is targeted more at gamers on a budget, the ASUS TUF Gaming B650-PLUS WIFI. Sporting support for the latest Ryzen 7000 series of processors, let's have a look at this board to see if it's any good. To recap, AMD launched its AM5 platform and the Ryzen 7000 series of processors alongside the range-topping X670E and X670 chipsets on 27 September 2022, and one thing that stood out was the value proposition or lack of it, seeing as X670E and X670 boards were really pricey, making lower-end Zen 4 parts, such as the Ryzen 5 7600X, questionable in terms of their price-to-performance ratio in the completed build with a X670 series motherboard. The launch of the B650E and B650 therefore strives to create value, hopefully, for potential Ryzen 7000 series consumers in the mid-range. Now to achieve these lower price points, AMD's paired away some of the features from the X670 family of chipsets so as to create the B650E and B650, as you can see on the screen. Now, the TUF Gaming B650-PLUS WIFI that we have here today, as its name implies, sports the entry-level AMD B650 chipset and sits within the TUF Gaming series of motherboard offerings targeted at gamers on a budget, where it places below the ROG Crosshair and ROG Strix series of boards and above the value-oriented Prime series of motherboard offerings by ASUS. In keeping with the design language of the TUF Gaming series of products, the B650-PLUS WIFI comes in a box sporting a silver-on-black color scheme with touches of yellow thrown in for contrast. Moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual summary of specs for this board. We'll take a closer look at these specs later in the video. On a side note, if you're new to this channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. Opening up the box, we see that the TUF Gaming B650-PLUS WIFI comes with a Wi-Fi antenna right here. Now we'll set aside the board for the moment to see what other accessories ASUS has included with the board. First up, we get two SATA 3 cables right here, a pack of M.2 drive screws and standoffs, as well as two packs of M.2 drive rubber pads to add additional height clearance for single-sided M.2 drives. We also get a motherboard manual and a DVD driver disc right here. A certificate of reliability that shows the battery of tests that some of the components on this board have been subjected to. An ASUS web storage promotional offer, as well as a sheet of TUF Gaming stickers. With that, onto the board itself. Here we have it, the TUF Gaming B650-PLUS WIFI. We see that ASUS has gone for a black and grey colour scheme with touches of yellow, and as you can see, military-like motifs are aplenty, which are very much in line with the TUF Gaming brand identity. The board comes with an integrated I/O shield design and has black colored heat sinks all around. Do note that this board does not come with built-in RGB LEDs of any sort, though it does come with plenty of RGB headers for you folks out there intending to spice up your PC build with RGB bling. I'll talk about these headers later on in the video. The VRM heatsinks for this board are pretty decently sized, and ASUS has included 12+2 power stages rated for up to 60 amps each. Unlike the X670E, the B650 has a single chipset design, and the SID chipset sits beneath this passive heatsink right here, with the TUF Gaming emblem emblazoned on it. For M.2 drive cooling, ASUS has got you covered with M.2 drive heatsinks for all three M.2 drive slots that this board comes with. Over on the rear of the board, we get some subtle TUF Gaming motifs, which are a nice touch, I suppose, in spite of the fact that most of these motifs would likely never see the light of day inside of a PC case. For memory support, the TUF Gaming B650-PLUS WIFI comes with 4 DDR5 slots with support for up to 128GB of RAM, and the DDR5 6400+ standard when overclocked, with plastic slots of a single tab design that ASUS calls QDIMM. It also features AMD's Expo technology, which are basically built-in overclocking profiles for DDR5 memory, similar to what XMP stands for in Intel's ecosystem. Near the RAM slots is a USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel header, which supports up to 2 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, as well as a USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-C front panel header. While still on the topic of USB connectivity, the bottom edge of the board houses 2 USB 2.0 front panel headers, with each header providing support for 2 USB 2.0 Type-A ports. Some interesting features to highlight: we get a Thunderbolt add-on card header with this board, which is to be used in conjunction with a Thunderbolt add-on card that is sold separately by ASUS. The said card adds Thunderbolt 4 ports, as well as DisplayPort connectors to your PC. Moving on, we also get a set of QLEDs up top that can help with troubleshooting PC issues when posting. In terms of expansion slots, this board comes with a PCIe 4.0 x16 slot that sports the ASUS Safe Slot Core Plus feature that reinforces the slot against heavy graphics cards. We also get two PCIe 4.0 x1 slots and a full-length PCIe 4.0 x16 slot that operates at X4 mode. In the storage department, ASUS has included 4 SATA 3 ports, with all ports in a right-angled configuration to aid with cable management. For M.2 drive support, this board comes with a single PCIe 5.0 X4 M.2 slot and two PCIe 4.0 X4 M.2 slots. Do note that all of these slots support NVMe M.2 SSDs only, where owners of M.2 SATA SSDs will be out of luck. That said, all of these slots come with the Q-latch feature, which facilitates the toolless installation of your M.2 SSDs. Potential owners of this board might want to note that this PCIe 4.0 X4 M.2 slot, slot M.2-3, shares bandwidth with this PCIe 4.0 X16 slot that operates at X4 mode, where if you have a NVMe M.2 drive operating at X4 mode in the M.2-3 slot, the said PCIe 4.0 X16 slot will be disabled. For audio, ASUS has included a higher-end Realtek ALC S1200A audio codec, along with what ASUS claims to be premium audio capacitors. Wired internet connectivity is courtesy of a Realtek chip that provides support for 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, while Wi-Fi is courtesy of MediaTek's MT7921 Wi-Fi 6 part, which also serves up Bluetooth 5.2. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with 7 fan headers, which are located in these regions of the board. Also included are 3 addressable RGB headers and a single 12-volt standard RGB header located right here. Moving over to the rear I/O, the TUF Gaming B650-PLUS WIFI goes for an integrated I/O shield design, and it comes with a DisplayPort 1.4 connector supporting display output of up to 8K resolution at 60Hz, a HDMI 2.1 port that supports display output of up to 4K resolution at 60Hz, 2 USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A ports, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C port, 4 USB 2.0 Type-A ports, with this port here supporting the BIOS flashback feature, a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port, a USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 Type-C port, Wi-Fi antenna connectors, a BIOS flashback button that allows end users to update the board's BIOS without a CPU, RAM, or graphics card installed, and your usual audio jack connectors. With that, the ASUS TUF Gaming B650-PLUS WIFI does what it's supposed to do, and that is to serve as a motherboard targeted at gamers on a budget who intend to adopt the AMD Ryzen 7000 series of processors for their PC build, perhaps with a chip such as the Ryzen 5 7600X or the Ryzen 7 7700X. It sports enough features that matter in a modern PC, such as PCIe 5.0 support for a M.2 drive, 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, and a more premium audio codec, topped off with a decent looking aesthetic. One issue that does need addressing, however, is the general value problem that is affecting the AMD AM5 platform as a whole. Now that Intel's 13th generation Raptor Lake processors have launched, with offerings such as the Core i5-13600K that is proving to be the new performance king offering the most bang for buck, AMD is faced with a situation where it will likely have to lower prices of its processor and motherboard offerings so as to stay competitive against Intel's Raptor Lake CPUs. As of early November 2022, the TUF Gaming B650-PLUS WIFI is available in Singapore for a price of around $417 through online and offline retailers, while for you international folks, this board can be had for around $240 from e-commerce sites such as Amazon. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.